Hello friends, welcome to this video tutorial by Perfect Web Solutions. My name is Imran Qasim, and in today's video tutorial of WordPress and Woocommerce for intermediate and advanced users, we are going to learn that how can we add a simple view counter in your post. What I mean that sometimes you want to see that how many times your post has been viewed, so you need to find a plugin for it. But with the help of this video tutorial, you don't need to find any plugin. You can simply put this small snippet inside your WordPress functions.php, and then you can echo out it anywhere you want on the post. So let's get started. I have already opened my favorite text editor, which is Sublime Text, and in that Sublime Text I have loaded my simple store theme, which is currently active theme of my WordPress installation of Woo store. So let me show you first. If I open local post slash Woo store, you will see the front end of this website. So what exactly I want to do here is, let me first show you that this is a child theme of Max store. So first I need to load a file from Max store theme as well and copy it inside. So from the Max store I need to copy. This all also depends on your theme, which theme you are using. So I'm not going to explain this thing that you need to find this file, because I know in this current simple store theme, this is the child theme of Max store. So I need to find this template, which is template for post meta, where I want to display the counter for the post. So I will copy this and I will paste it inside my sample store here. And that means now I can override it. And when I open this post meta, you will see a line here. This is the line I have added to get the post count. So I will remove it so I can show you from the start. So now again, I will reload the page and this error will be gone. So what I mean, I need to add count view counts here. And it will show like this. So this is the template file which is responsible for displaying that counter. So as I don't have currently how many counts are there, so I will just put a static info here. Views, and I reload the page and you will see here views, and in the front of view I can put here zero for the time being, and you will see zero views, zero. So this will be increased as the people view your post. So to do this, first we need to go over functions.php file, and at the end we need basically two functions. One is get post view and the other one is set post view. So first we see how can we create a set view post. The function set post views, this is the function which will set the post view, and this function we will be adding into the single .php file by using the filter for content. So that is why I will add here content as a accepting parameters. And here first we need a key. So count key is equal to post count view. So this is the count key, and then this is the count variable which will get post meta. The get post meta function will get a particular post key which you can assign here. So post ID will be get the ID. So it will automatically fetch the ID from the current active post, and here we will put the key. So key is which we define is count key. And true and false means, true means it will assign the value to this count variable. So now, initially, if we check print into count is equals to empty. So it means there is no value inside this count variable, because in start there must not be any value. So it will be empty. So if it's empty, the count will be zero. And then we here use delete post meta, and then I will put here meta key, get the ID will be added first, and then meta key will be count key, and then let it to be empty. After that I will use add post meta, and here I need to put value first, the ID, get the ID, and after that the meta key will be the count key, and you know, as you know, the meta value will be the count value, and that it will be default. So with the help of this small snippet, if trimmed account, I will add the post meta. So what else if people are viewing more than once? So of course there will be something in the count, so we need to increment it. So in the else part, we will do count plus plus. So it will increase, and then we will use update post meta function. And here again, we will put get the ID. And of course, meta key is count key, and meta value will be count after increment. And it doesn't, we don't need it. So this function has been completed. And at the end, we will return the content. We don't need to return here anything except this variable content. So we will comment it out, set the post view count. So this will set the post view count. Next function we need is get the post view count. This is the actual function which will display the counts. So here we will put function get post view, and then we will here pass the post ID. So in this one, same again, count key will be the same which we use to set the view. So copy this one and paste it here. So this if portion will be the same from here to here. If portion is the same. So what we are telling is that count of get ID, and here we need to change it to the post ID. We are getting from here this post ID. This is the same. So delete and add the post meta. Otherwise, what it will do, of course, it will count and it will turn the count. And here we will use return 0. For 0 means there will be 0 view. And here else, all we don't need to put here else. If of course if trim into 0, it will do and return this. So here we will just need to put return count dot, simply we will return the count. So here we will simply return the count, how many count it is. We don't need to count here. Count function plus plus function will be done here, otherwise it will be double. So if there is, so return, if we do, or even we can do like this, we will return, because we are setting here count is equal to 0, so it will return 0 here as well. So count is 0. So let's check it, get post views, copy this, and first we need to add this function into our filter. So the filter is add underscore filter the content comma set post views. Right, this is the way we write it. So one parameter is accept and one is the priority. So they are one and one. That means. Furthermore, as you know, we need to put this one under only when we are viewing the post. So we need to put here a check if is a single. And if there is a single post and then do this, so end it. If this is a single post, then do this procedure up to here. Otherwise, simply return the contents and do nothing, and no view count adding, no nothing will be added here. So this one will be only added, these meta keys will only be added to the post. You can use here custom posts or pages, anything you want, you can do it. If you want to do this with the pages as well, you can do it, remove this check if it's single. So because if there is a page, then we will check here if it's page. So that's it. So we need to copy this function, and then we need to go template. And here in this function, I will do echo and get the ID pass here. Simply save this and then reload. And if everything goes well, we will again see view is 0. So now just click on any post. And you find that view is 0 because we have just viewed it, not refreshed it. So I again reload the page. And now you see the view goes to 1. So every time anyone will visit this page, this counter will be increased like this. see views too. And if you go to home, it won't increase here. So it means if I reload the page, it is not adding it to 4 because we are not on the single page. We are on the home page. So this is this video. You have 0 views because we have returned here 0. This count is equal to 0 if there is empty count. So this is the video tutorial where you can easily add a view counter inside your WordPress site. So I'm sure you have liked and you will like this video, and if you do, please press the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button and do click the bell icon as well, because as soon as I upload a new video, you will get notified if you click on the bell icon. If you haven't, you won't get notified with my latest video. So this is the video tutorial for today. I hope you like it. Thank you very much for watching this video tutorial. Till then, take care and bye.